Good afternoon from Xfinity Center. 82-60, the Terps over Gardner Webb.
Yeah, a good win. I mean, when you consider you have either your big men here, my eyes, they were a little luggish, and then number 10 came in, Daryl Morsel. And what do you think of his play? 18 points.
I liked it. Some turnovers early. Technical foul on Bender down here where he got two fouls in one play. Just an interesting start to this one, a little sluggish. The tech on Bender started a little bit of unraveling early. If this was a good team, I think it would have been a different story, especially early on.
It was, I don't know, these games, you got three more of them on top of it. Wasn't a big house here today because of the weather, but it wasn't that bad. It filled up a little bit. But overall, they took care of business. I don't think they ever trailed, maybe 3-2 or something, but they held it wire to wire. It was never really a close game. However, go ahead.
These games have just gotten to the point where it's just slow part of the season. You can't really get into it yet. I mean, between the Ohio game and this one, does this place fill up? Combined crowds?
Probably not. You know, he looked good today, though. He got a chance to play to make.
Yeah, earlier in the season on our podcast, Jordan and I both pointed him out as a guy who has, he has a shot, and he's a big man. And if he could get going, maybe he could be that second Justin Jackson-ish position. He looked like he could play that part today. Maybe starting to slide Bender out of the lineup because he's a big man. He can dribble. He can shoot. I like him a lot. I think he can contribute as the season goes on.
Meyer Consulting Engineers. In the past 5 years, our organization has completed over 1,300 projects in the U.S. and abroad, including many structures at the University of Maryland. For structural engineering and materials testing and inspection, call Meyer Consulting Engineers.
We talked a lot about it, and when Morsel came into the game, he's a really tough guy on this team. Especially if Fernando and Jackson aren't here. He's a tough kid. He really is, and he played like it today. That's the one thing you and Wayne told me last year. By the way, Wayne's on the road today. That's why he's not here. And Jordan is at the North Dakota State game?
Yeah, they're marching on. Yeah.
Now, is that semis?
No, it is the quarterfinal, and they'll be going on to the semifinals.
Okay. So when he came into the game, the toughness equaled out. Gardner Webb was a pretty scrappy team, and it seems like these little guards always do well against us. I'm not sure why, but whoever their little guard was had a nice game.
Yeah, I liked the way that Gardner Webb played because there were multiple times in this game, and it didn't really happen until the end, where they could have slipped away and lost this one by 40, but they kept on pushing.
Right, and you know what else? They good sets on offense, some really stupid turnovers. I don't know how many turnovers we wound up with today, but it wasn't as bad. With 3 minutes to go in the first half, we only had one. And then we had four of them in like 2 minutes, you know?
Yeah.
Morsel seems to turn over a little bit, but wow, 18 points from a freshman on any level against any team is nothing to sneeze at.
What I didn't like today is Maryland was making the extra pass and the shot wasn't going in, especially some points where there was a basket down there where they passed it off to Wiley. He was wide open and he missed it. And I originally thought it was Morsel because we've seen some problems with him making the wide open ones. But it was Wiley. These guys that you expect to make these wide open threes, they seem to miss.
They did, but you know, it's hard to get really into a game like this. And you take care of what's happening. And the defense was very good, in my opinion. I mean, they got most of their points as the game wound down. And, you know, overall, it was a win. Next game is Tuesday night. Who is that against?
Is it Catholic U?
Yeah, Catholic, then who?
Then it's UMBC, then Fairleigh Dickinson. And then you get into it.
Then Penn State comes to town, a good Penn State team. But you know what's funny, Mason? Next year, when they go to 20 games in conference, they'll be playing two more games in this time. And you know what? It would make for such a better season. Speaking of which, give everybody the surprise result today.
Well, BC tops Duke. Early conference games seem to be tough for some of these teams. They had it coming.
Yeah, Duke's been challenged and challenged, and they probably spotted BC a 15-point lead. It could come back. That would be my guess. And Duke's not unbeatable. As good as they are.
Right now, they aren't unbeatable. later today, it's one of my favorites of the year, Army and Navy.
Oh, can't wait. Who do you like?
I like Army.
Why?
Back to back. I don't know. It's
always,
you
always
got to
like Navy. Navy's 2.5 favorite. Like him a lot. Who do you like in the big game tomorrow? Ravens and the Steelers.
I think the Steelers are actually going to win this one. Antonio Brown is just too good. Now that Jimmy Smith's out, you said it wouldn't matter if Smith was playing or not.
Well, he would beat Smith. I mean, he beats everybody.
Yeah. I just think the Steelers' offense will get it rolling. But with Shazier out, you know, it puts a whole
new
element.
And Smith-Schuster out. That's a big factor.
Yeah, maybe DHB is going to get out there tomorrow night.
It could be. But Smith-Schuster had 2 touchdowns against the Ravens the first game. Ravens' defense has been high. Let's be realistic. They don't need the game. A lot of things point to the Ravens in this game. And that being said, yeah, he doesn't want to see the turtle. Look who it is, turtle. All right, man, let's wrap it up.
All right, well, In the Nest is on tomorrow, and a new episode of the Terp Talk Young Terps podcast will be dropping tomorrow or Monday morning. Terps 82, Gardner Webb 60. Good afternoon from Xfinity Center.
All right, goodbye, everybody. Drive safely. So make your hands clap.